Hey YouTubers, AMR here with another Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 video. I mean, I have delayed a big gap between the two Xenoverse 2 videos. Well, this video is a how-to video on how to get the Dragon Balls as fast as possible. There are other methods, but for me, this method is the best. First of all, you basically, as you can see here, Balls Collector. This guy is the one that I've been farming Dragon Balls with. I'm gonna delete her because she's unneeded. Once you do with this with one character, you can't do it again, but the Dragon Ball is gonna be in your inventory. So basically, create a brand new character, relax. So, doesn't matter who it needs to be, it can be anyone. So, I'll just do a scene here. And you have to do it, you know, the more faster you want it, you have to do it more quicker. So at the moment, I'm just, you know, messing around. You have to obviously name it. So I'm just gonna name this for the tubers, right? I named her that, and let's return and confirm. The best thing is I like it put close up and nice and personal. That's because you're gonna need to fight at least two people. Actually, the second person is gonna give you the Dragon Ball guaranteed. The first person has got to do with the story mode. Right now, guys, I'm just gonna cut a chunk of the video. That's because after you created your character and after you've connected to the universe server and all that is done, all you're gonna do is spam the options button, so you skip through all the cutscenes and everything. And some of the cutscenes kind of need to be skipped with the X button, so spam the X button after that. So I'll meet you after I skipped all the cutscenes. There's no need for me to put this in the video because obviously it's gonna be a waste of your time. I know how two videos need to be as fast as possible so you guys can get to the point. So here we go, I'm gonna just skip everything. Right, guys, we're back. After skipping all the cutscenes, you're gonna get to this dialogue scene, mash the X button, and it's gonna tell you to open your map. As you guys know, you just open your map like that, flash it, and then press the square button to get anywhere, then press the L2 button to go to the first place. To be honest, this is not even a part of the tutorial, man. You guys should know all of this, if you're that far through the game and you want the Dragon Ball.
Hello.
You guys obviously know all this. You're just basically starting in the game. Just zoom in all the place. I mean, your first try, you might be a bit slow, but, you know, other than that, you'll get faster. By the way, you're not gonna obviously get, you don't need to do this fast, but if you wanna do this, it's gonna be a bit time consuming to get all 7 balls. It's gonna take you at least about 50 minutes to get all 7 balls. But if you do it faster like I do, it's gonna take you half an hour to get all 7 balls. Seriously, it will. Oh, come on, I'm just need to skip this. I'm doing this fast, so I can just show you how fast this can be done. Right, here we are. The first fight that you need to come across is defeat Raditz. Easy as that. That's it. Just skip all the cutscenes. Damn it, I did a bit like too slow. Kick the crap out of Raditz, and after that, that's it, you're done. You're on your way to the, basically, the Dragon Ball. Actually, you're not doing that quickly, but, you know, you'll be there. After I just kicked the crap out of Raditz, come on, dude. I mean, I've been playing Gran Turismo recently so much, I'm addicted to that game, that I literally forgot all my combos and stuff in this game. Yes, block his guard. Beat your pass. Come on, Raditz. Another flipper. Guys, come on, you can kick the cup like fast. I'm gonna make this sure YouTubers get all the 7 balls and this for whatever they want. I mostly use this method to grab that trophy for the final last 3 characters. For the trophy there, you have to get every single character. Right, that's one hurdle out of the way. Skip all the cutscene, blah blah blah. You also level up, of course. Just skip. Right, tubers, after all that long times, you know, you need to spend a few precious seconds of yours to customize the character, because it will make the next fight a bit more easier. And you just gotta boost your attributes, and the attributes that you're gonna boost is your basic attack. That will up your little game pretty fast. And next up, you're gonna go to the bloody academy, which I completely forgot where it is. Here it is. You go to the academy and you fight this fighter, and now you will guarantee always get a Dragon Ball. Always. Here we go. She's called, what's she called? Sanud? San? What? Anyways, go to her, kick the crap out of her, and you will get a Dragon Balls. However, you can only do this once per new character. So after you get the Dragon Ball, delete the character, do it again. And then summon Shenron on your main character and wish for whatever you guys want. So basically, you know, I mostly use this for my final trophy, which was getting every single character. I needed this to get all the 3 dragons, the Mega Shenron, Ice Shenron, and Fire Shenron, and also Hit, which you need this to do to get unlock him as a character. And I got my platinum, because that was my last trophy. So this does take maximum 10 minutes, guys, it takes per Dragon Ball, right? time it can be much more faster if you get used to it, because I mean the first two Dragon Balls is gonna be, you're gonna take your time to get it, because obviously you're not gonna be used to doing it. Once you get used to it, guys, it's gonna take like literally around 40 minutes maximum to get 7 Dragon Balls. That's the fastest I did it on. And then that's it. You just do that once a day if you find it time consuming. That's it, just do it once a day. I mean, look at that. I haven't even finished twerking yet, and that's it, got the Dragon Ball. There we go. Got the Dragon Ball, guys. You guys are probably thinking, got the Dragon Ball? What do you mean, got the Dragon Ball? That is it. You can't see it anywhere. Basically, you're going to be seeing it right about... Right, now. Come on. There you go. We got the 4-star Dragon Ball, guys. Basically, yeah, we got the 4-star Dragon Ball. It's basically, here it is, in your bloody bag, equipment list. Where the hell is the Dragon Ball? No, it's not. It actually is an equipment list. What am I doing, dude? Come on. What the hell am I doing? It's in my item list. Dude, I'm losing the plot here. There we go. We've got one. Actually, no. We got that. There we go. 4-star Dragon Balls. As you can see, I don't need the Dragon Balls anymore because I've literally destroyed everything. So there you have it, guys. That's the easiest possible way to get Dragon Balls in this game. And if you want to repeat the process, all you're going to do is basically go back to the Dragon Ball, script back to the screen as fast as possible. Thanks to these loading times, you know, they're going to waste the time, but whatever. Like I said, do it once a day and you'll get that trophy that you're after. You'll get the wish that you're after. And here, for that tubers, I'm sorry guys, I'm just gonna delete you right here and there. And there we have it, we're back to stage 1 again. Create a new character, and you will get a Dragon Ball. Basically, that Dragon Ball, this is my main character, he's gonna have it. This guy is absolutely OP. If you would like to see this guy in action, be fighting online players with this guy, write down in the comments below, give this video a like, subscribe, and share with all them guys that are trouble finding their balls. Thank you for watching, guys. Stay awesome. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, because I really need subscribers right now. Peace out, guys. Peace out.